And welcome back to Reliable Sources. I'm Frank Sesno, filling in for Brian Stelter today. Fox News is facing big issues right now, including one with network superstar Sean Hannity, who's currently on vacation until Tuesday. The vacation comes after a number of advertisers pulled support from his show after he continued to focus on the unproven story of slain former DNC staffer Seth Rich. Fox News insists Hannity will have a job when he returns, but we've heard that one before. Well, joining me to consider it all, Eric Wemple, media reporter for The Washington Post, who rejoins us. Jane Hall, communication professor at American University and a former Fox News contributor. Eric, first to you. You wrote that Fox is, I'm using your words here, developing an unhealthy relationship with vacation. Here's what you said. Sean Hannity is under pressure from advertisers, media critics, and the force of common sense after he promoted a conspiracy about the July 2016 killing of Seth Rich, a staffer at the Democratic National Committee. So how does it affect Hannity now?
Well, you know, Bill O'Reilly was supposed to have gone on vacation back in April, and he was in the middle of a more severe advertiser problem, and he never came back. And so when Jesse Waters said something stupid on Fox News air after that, and he went on vacation, people said, oh, maybe he won't come back. Now, Hannity, after having, you know, aired the Seth Rich conspiracy theory, over and over and over again, and he's under pressure from advertisers now too. He said he's going on vacation. Now, Fox News put out a statement saying that he is actually on vacation. He'll be back Tuesday.
It is Memorial Day weekend.
Memorial Day weekend. So enjoy your vacation, Sean Hannity. The point I was making is that Fox News can never have a controversy and a vacation, and vacation is there to make us feel better, to restore us. And they just don't have
Jane
that relationship.
Hall, you were a columnist, or you were a contributor at Fox, yes. And you never took a vacation, as I understand.
No, yeah. Never.
What's going on? Is there any indication that Sean Hannity's in trouble for this?
Well, you know, he hasn't suffered the advertiser boycotts, although Media Matters has been listing all of his advertisers in an attempt to try to drive people away. I think he, you know, because he is the last man standing practically in their original primetime lineup, you know, from it would seem to me that they do not want to lose him.
Any suggestion that this is tied to his vociferous support of Donald Trump?
Well, he has been the safe haven for Donald Trump.
Is that a liability for him?
No, I don't think so. I mean, I think they've got a split between the news, even more, it was always there between the newscast and the primetime host. Right. You know, what I think is regrettable is that while Trump is doubling down on many things about fake news, Sean Hannity says, I'm not even a journalist, and he makes this despicable connection and repeats this thing that the FoxNews.com retracted. He continues to talk about it. So maybe they're going to have a thing where he doesn't talk about it anymore on the air, but he's going to talk about it all over Twitter.
Eric, here's what Fox said in their retraction. The article was not initially subjected to the high degree of editorial scrutiny we require of all of our, for all our reporting upon appropriate review. The article was found not to meet those standards and has since been removed.
Right. Those are the standards of the news side. Now, it should be noted that they left it up for a week before doing that. So those you know, exacting editorial standards could use some help, I think. However, Hannity has none. Okay? He has none. He has said, told a Huffington Post, Michael Calderon, he said that when he finally did drop the Seth Rich story the other night, he said, I'm going to leave it for a while. He said that that was entirely his decision, which indicates to me that he has no editorial supervision, none whatsoever. And so my point is that I'm not that high on boycotts. I'm not a huge boycott fan. But that's what happened. These people are editing Sean Hannity because nobody else
would. I would doubt that he wasn't spoken to. I mean, you know, we also have this interesting younger, older Murdochs. What do they want? I mean, I think that he was spoken to. I would imagine the family threatened legal action. He went on the air. The thing that really seemed so unctuous and offensive was, I really sympathize with the family about Seth, as if he knew Seth Rich, and I'm going to leave this for now, and
for
I'm going to keep pursuing the truth.
Yeah.
So he still is pursuing this conspiracy theory.
Meanwhile, they've been seeing some decline in the ratings, so there are lots of issues going on at Fox.
Right.
Eric, Jane, thank you both very much.